Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to discuss the following question. And the question says that, restrict the domain of f of x is equal to x minus 1 whole square, so its inverse exists. Also find its inverse. Now we know that inverse of a function y is equal to f of x exists if the function is 1:1, this can be known algebraically, that is, we find its inverse, and if the plus minus sign exists in its inverse, then it is not 1:1 function. And to make it 1:1 function, we restrict domain of f of x. With this key idea, we proceed to the solution. Now we are given a function f of x is equal to x minus 1 whole square, and from the key idea we know that inverse of a function y is equal to f of x exists if the function is 1:1. Now, its inverse will exist if it is 1:1 function, that is, when we find its inverse, then value of y should not be in terms of plus minus sign, because it indicates that for one value of y, there corresponds two values of x, so inverse found will not be a function. So let us find its inverse. Here, domain is given by x, which belongs to the set of real numbers. Now in this function, we replace f of x by y, and we get y is equal to x minus 1 whole square. Now we switch x and y, and we get x is equal to y minus 1 whole square. Now we solve this equation for y, and we get plus minus of square root of x is equal to y minus 1, that is, taking square roots on both sides of the equation, we get plus minus square root of x is equal to y minus 1, which implies that 1 plus minus square root of x is equal to y, or we can also write it as y is equal to 1 plus minus square root of x. Now we replace y by f inverse of x, so we have f inverse of x is equal to 1 plus minus square root of x. So, it is not 1:1 because it is having two values of x corresponding to the same value of y. And here, domain is all real numbers. Now, if we want to find its inverse, then we will have to make it 1:1 function by restricting its domain. Let us see its graph. Now here is the graph of the equation y is equal to x minus 1 whole square. It is an upward parabola with vertex 1, 0. Now here we see that for each y, there are two corresponding values of x. Here, for point with coordinates 0, 1 and point with coordinates 2, 1, we see that for same value of y, that is, for 1, we have two values of x, that is, x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 2. So, it is not 1:1 function, but instead of taking domain as x belonging to all real numbers, If we take only those values of x which are greater than or equal to 1, we have only this remaining curve. Now see, for each value of y, there is exactly one value of x. So now the function has become 1 to 1. So, we restrict the domain. To x is greater than or equal to 1, or we can write it as x minus 1 is greater than or equal to 0. Now, for x is greater than or equal to 1, we will find its inverse using the same procedure. Here we have y is equal to x minus 1 whole square. For x is greater than or equal to 1, now we switch x and y and we get x is equal to y minus 1 whole square. Now we shall solve this equation for y and we get square root of x is equal to y minus 1. Since we have taken the value of x as greater than or equal to 1, so we will not take value of y minus 1 as plus minus square root of x. We have taken only positive square root of x. It further implies that square root of x plus 1 is equal to y, or we can write it as y is equal to square root of x plus 1. So now we have f inverse of x is equal to square root of x plus 1, which is the inverse of f of x is equal to x minus 1 whole square. For x is greater than or equal to 1, which is the required answer. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.